Hi everyone, I'm Korbin Grant from Young Living Purpose. Today I'm going to show you how to throw an awesome homeschool party.
You're on the couch, blowing up my phone. You don't want to come out, but you don't want to be alone.
You are throwing a homeschool party. This is awesome. You came to the exact right place to learn how to throw an awesome homeschool party right here. So, I have thrown so many homeschool parties, and they've all been awesome. Except for that one, but that doesn't count. So, we are going to throw a homeschool party. Now, what is the first thing that you want to do for your homeschool party? And the first thing you need to think about is location. Location, location, location. Not only important for real estate, but also for finding a good spot to throw an awesome homeschool party. And you want to know where is the best place to throw this party. At the park, at the beach, at the roller skating rink, at the ice skating rink, at a house. Like, where do you want it that it will be the best and the most fun? Well, I'd say that you probably want your location to go with your theme. And I highly recommend that you have a theme, because if you have a theme and people know exactly what your party's about, they'll be more inclined to come and you guys will have a much better time at your homeschool party. When you're doing a theme for your party, what kind of theme do you want? Do you want a barbecue party, a pool party, a birthday party, a dancing party, a picnic party? Like, you need to find out what you want at your party. And that needs to go exactly with your location, because if you're having a pool party, you don't want to throw that at a ice skating rink. Like, don't do that. That's nobody would come to that. You can do a pool party at a pool or a water park. Like, that would be awesome. The point is, you need a good theme to match with your good location, and they need to complement each other. We're gonna have a house party. So you are having an awesome party now, and you have a good location, and you have an awesome theme to go with it. So what else do you need to do? You need a bunch of awesome activities that you can do and everyone can play, so that everyone is excited and everyone is doing fun things. And so ideas is like frisbee, volleyball, dancing, pin the tail on the donkey. Like, what do you want to do? This is very important. And I would do games where all the ages can play, but then I'd also do some where like some anybody can play, like individual games, just so everyone is happy and then everyone can play what they want to play. So the next thing that you need to do to throw an awesome homeschool party is you need to market your party. How are you going to spread the word? Who are you going to tell? And why is it going to be awesome? These are the things that you need to get out to people so that they know what is happening at this party and they'll be like, oh my gosh, I want to come to this party. This is going to be so much fun. That is what you need to do. How I spread the word out to people is I use Evite, because it's an easy way for me to just get the party and what's going to be happening all out to people, and they can respond and they can tell me how many people they're bringing or what they're bringing or if they can or cannot come. And that is very easy for me to do. Who you're going to tell, that is very important, because you probably don't want to bring any awkward people to your party. I would tell your best friend, other homeschoolers, your family, all these people that you love to hang out with and that would love to come to your party. You probably want to think about who you're going to tell when you're thinking about your theme, because you don't really want to throw a pool party and invite a bunch of people who can't swim, or throw a football party and invite a bunch of people who don't like football. Why is your party going to be awesome? You are having an awesome party, but you need to get other people excited about your awesome party, or else they're not gonna come. If you're not that excited about your party, then other people won't be that excited about your party. But if you're like, party, this is gonna be great, dude, are you coming? Then they'll be like, yeah, I'm coming to your party. And then people come to your party and everyone has a great time. And that is what you need to do. You need to tell people why your party is going to be awesome. Okay, so now you have people coming to your party and you have your theme and you know where you're gonna have this party and you feel like you're ready to go, but don't stop there, because there's a ton that you still need to do. You need to prepare your party. You need to think about food. What kind of food are you gonna have? And your food probably can match your theme, because that'd be cool. Like, if you're having a barbecue, obviously you wanna have a barbecue and you don't really wanna have like some nice little fancy dinner. You wanna have a barbecue. So you need to think about food. That's very important. Another thing that you want to think about when you're thinking about food is your budget. You don't want to make a bunch of food and find out your next paycheck that you spent way too much money on food for this party. You need to plan, you need to pair. Are you going to have, is it going to be a potluck? I think a potluck is the best thing to do, because then everyone's pitching in to help with the food, because that's a big thing for homeschool parties, because there are a lot of large families that come and there's a lot, and food is a very big problem sometimes. Is it a potluck? Is it catered? What's your budget? You need to think about your budget, because if you don't think about your budget, you're going to end up spending way too much money on food. You also want utensils and supplies, because if you have a bunch of food but you can't serve it to people, then your food is useless. Number five, This is the last thing. People are arriving at your party. What do you do? Dude, party. Awesome house party. House party? You don't want to come out, but you don't want to be alone. Birthday party? A pool party. A birthday party? A barbecue party. A birthday party? Sit tight right where you are, bro, because I'll be at your door in 10 minutes. Whatever you got on, girl, stay in it. You ain't got to leave the house. We can cut that. We can cut that, though, right? We'll have a house party. We don't need no party. Hi everyone, I'm Korbin from This is how you set a party.
I have no clue. We're
gonna ask the other guy.
Today I'm gonna show you.
Well, yeah, I'm excited. That's gonna be fun. Yeah, that's what I wanna do. Yeah, you're welcome to your party.
Awesome. Come to a party. Yeah.
Parties, because I've done so many, and all of them have been awesome.
Hey, party! Meow!
A barbecue party? A homeschool? Yes. Homeschool party. We're gonna have a house party. If you wanna be a home party, we're gonna have a house party. Party.
Today I'm gonna show you how to throw an awesome homeschool party.
You gotta leave the house to have a good time. I'm gonna bring the good time home to you.